Hi guys, let's try to do a repair job on the doors of my barn here. As you can see, the lower side here is completely rotten and the upper part is still okay. So what we will do, we will replace the lower part with an iron profile. And also here we will fit some iron profiles, and then we remove half of the woodwork. Half of the lower part of the woodwork we will also replace. Here I did it already on the other door. It's already done, and it has been a good result. So here also, the lower part. Here I used some iron screwed against the wood, that was still okay, and here I used also some iron to replace the rotten wood. And here the lower part was not completely wasted here, so here I only needed to do a small piece, and then I cut it away the lower part of the wood, and I replaced it with full material. So that's what we will try to do also here. Hi guys, so I finished the second door also, all painted. This one, this lower part is new. And here I added the bottom part here was all rotten. So I added a metal one. Here I added the green one, that's completely in metal. And now the other side is done also. Here I cleaned also the barn. I used I used my compressor, air compressor, to blow off all dust and all spider rests. So the walls are still like that. I will do that the next time, to do it with water. But now at least it's clean again. Here also the stable, I cleaned it also with my compressor. So all the dust and all the spider webs are gone now. Here it has no point to do the floor with water, because when they come in again, it's dirty again anyhow. So now what's left to do is to repaint this door here. And here I took already off all the rotten wood, and now I painted already the outsides. This one side I will also paint. It's a small protection wood that I have here, and this here is the plate that will go against it. It's finished from one side. You see, it's finished like this. So I still have to paint it from the both sides, and then we'll add it against it. Watching me painting, it's maybe not the most exciting thing to watch, so I will make a time lapse of it. So guys, that's the paint job finished. I've done all the two doors. The window I will still do today. So then it's finished here. I will redo the doors tonight when it's a little bit drier, in 5 hours time, 4 hours times. So that's the stable done. Only thing that I would like to do here still this year is the lightings, they are okay, but the cabling, actually I would like to redo the cabling, because the recabling is not done properly. So I will redo the cabling before winter, and also replace here all these wall plugs. Maybe this junction box is still okay, but the junction box, I will open them and check them. Also, the power here is also not perfect. The power comes there, under the ground, is going under the ground to the house, but that's just a 4 square millimeter cable. Two-Face. And it's a little bit, it's not, it's the distance is more or less 80 meters until the house. And I get too much power loss over the cable. So when I try to start a 220 volt engine, it has difficulties to start, and sometimes it doesn't start at all. So with the eye, with in March, I will have one cow that gives milk. So I think I will buy a small milking unit working on 220 volts. So for that one, it's better that there will be, that there is a proper power cable connected to the house. So what I will do before March, I think it's the best, is to dig in a new cable to the house. I will place a 5 times 10 square millimeters. That's more than enough. And then I will have no problems with power supply. I don't need three phase here, but maybe in the future. But maybe in the future I will buy a three phase generator, and then I can maybe power my home when there is a power outage. But that's for the future. For the time being, we will see what we do. Okay, guys, thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.